Zach Robinson. I'm Steve Palazzolo, and it's going to be a weekly segment this year, the Big Time Throws of the Week. We're going to be showing you the best throws from the NFL week, and it's all about the highest graded throws in the PFF system. That's what we're looking for with Big Time Throws. Best ball location, touch, and essentially a Big Time Throw, Zach, is putting a receiver in position to make a big play. We might show some drops on here too. Just so happens we've got some catches on this one, but it's all about the Big Time Throws. Let's get into the first one. It's your boy. You made sure that he's on here.
We had to get Patrick Mahomes week one. We're going to count it down from number three. Patrick Mahomes against the Chargers. Everybody saw the debut that he had. Had a few big time throws. This was by far his best throw of the day, though. And we're just going to see a pretty simple concept that the Chiefs are going to run. They're going to try to lock down Travis Kelce with the corner right here. And then they got a matchup with the fullback. Sherman is going to be on an edge player here. And we're going to have a nice matchup up the sideline. And so many times we talk about Patrick Mahomes' arm strength. This is kind of just a pure arm talent where he shows off his touch.
How important is the pre-snap recognition here? Because Chargers like to play their cover three, and they don't disguise a whole lot. So are you able to dictate this matchup if you're the Chiefs?
Yeah, this is definitely a scheme design play. They probably had this in their score zone, realizing once they cross the 50, hey, we could get into the slot formation. As long as the corner is up top, we know we're going to get a zone coverage here. So they got a great man zone indicator here, and then he just lets it have at it.
All right, let's check out the actual throw because he has the matchup he wants, believe it or not, a fullback. That's how good Mahomes is. He's making a fullback look good. But like you said, he's on an edge defender.
Yeah, exactly. He makes that quick confirmation that exactly the defender locks down on Travis Kelce, and then the rest is him just making a sweet throw here.
So that's Emmanuel trying to cover Sherman down the field. Excellent ball location there. That's why it's the big time throw. Hitting him in stride, allowing for that catch
and run. Yeah, this shot right here over the outstretched defender, just a great throw and one of the many plays that he made, but this was definitely the best throw.
So Mahomes had the best big time throw of the year so far back in the preseason. And here in week one, only third in week one, but
we'll
expecting to see a little bit more going forward. Let's get to number two. All right, off to New England now, where Tom Brady makes the list at number two. A very unique pass, Zach, because it's a big-time throw, but man, was it a bad decision as Brady throws into double coverage with Gronk?
It was something we saw the Texans do over and over, and we'll get into kind of the scheme in a second, but he sees that he's got two defenders with his back to him. He feels like he can let it go. Obviously, he's got complete faith in Rob Gronkowski to make these tight catches, but we're going to see he moves the safety enough to feel okay about the throw, but when he let it go, even Gronk explained it in his post-game press conference that he was shocked that he let it go, but obviously he's got a ton of faith that he can make that play.
All right, let's watch the play. Let's see how it goes. Brady's looking left, looks back right, chucks it up, and right on Gronk's hands. There was a little controversy. Did he hold on to it? But
the shot right here, I mean, there is one place that ball can end up, and it was right where he put it, and Rob Gronkowski, they say, there's no defense for a perfect throw. That's the exact example that you need to see for that. But scheme-wise, we saw this from the Houston Texans, I think 10 times in the game where they play true one double. I think double coverage gets kind of maybe generalized a little bit where it could be a guy's getting double, but it's actually a zone. You got an underneath defender and a safety over the top. These were true doubles on Gronk where they're playing man-to-man across the board. And they're saying these two guys are man-to-man in and out on Rob Gronkowski. Something you just don't see. Obviously, a ton of respect for him, but you just don't see this from time to time. You might see it in the red zone, but they did it continuously throughout the game, and this is one of those clips. And this just shows, I think this clip's going to show Brady move his eyes, get the safety away where he can feel good about making this throw down the seam.
Yeah, you can see the safety already moving off the hash away, and there's the double. This is the decision he's making. He flips his eyes back, and he's going to chuck it up into the double team and trust Gronk to make a play.
Yeah, it's wild. He sees that both defenders have their back to him. So at worst, this is probably going to be an incomplete pass, maybe a pass defense if the defender gets his eyes around. But incredible throw and obviously a great catch, too.
The ball location, the perfect ball location up and away from coverage makes it the number two big-time throw of the week. And now it's time for number one. All right, the number one throw of the week is Aaron Rodgers in Green Bay. Zach, this is an incredible display of quarterbacking. Let's talk through this play. This was by far Rodgers' best throw of the night.
Yeah, it was incredible. Everybody saw the location and the throw that this thing ended up in. We're going to talk a little bit about the process and what it took to get to this throw, but let's go ahead and run the clip. We're going to see, first thing is, and no Khalil Mack on this play, definitely helped him out. He was able to sit back in a clean pocket and deliver an absolute strike on one leg, mind you, in the second half here. To Allison, huge play in the game. They're down 20-3. At that point, it was obviously a huge play.
Yeah, and I think when you look at Rodgers' ability to go through progressions, and this is similar to the Brady throw because it's not his first read. He comes back to it, and the ability to just pick up the target and then throw a pinpoint throw, that is why it's a big-time throw.
It's insane. He ends up getting to his fourth option on the play. We're going to see his eyes work from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4, but usually a fourth option is a check down or something underneath that you're expecting to come into your vision. He's spotting a go route as his fourth guy in the progression and then deliver an accurate throw. But we're going to see on this play that he's going to try to use his eyes to get the safety to the middle of the field. And he wants to initially throw this go ball to Davante Adams on the left. He's going to have Jimmy Graham coming on a crosser. And then out of the picture is Randall Cobb on a seam. He's going to go 1 to 2 to 3 before he spots up Allison in the fourth progression, and we're going to see just him work his eyes on this shot here. So we're going to see he tries to move the safety, doesn't like it, 1, 2, 3, 4.
And then just drops it right on him.
Perfect throw, and this is going to be a great shot of it here. We'll slow it down here. You can see his eyes. He wants to get the safety there. He does a great job of moving him. Davante Adams actually inside releases, and he doesn't like it. Davante Adams isn't looking, so he's going to come off of that. Jimmy Graham's number two here. He spots him up. And then the rest you're going to see 3 to 4 and an absolutely perfect throw. So a lot going into that play other than just an absolute perfect throw.
And how difficult is that to pick up a target 50-plus yards downfield and put it, coverage as tight as it is, that was the only place that he could catch it.
Yeah, no, it's incredible. Some of these guys' ability to, like you were saying, just spot, pick it up, and then know the trajectory and the throw that needs to be made is what makes those guys the best.
So there you have it. It's our big time throws of the week. We'll have this segment every single week with Zac and I. Let us know in the comments what you think was the best big time throw of the week.